Orthodoxy, becoming Orthodox, has just been the greatest gift we could ever have received.
There is a church in Macon. And I made Google, and I figured out, coming here, I see nice, nice building, very friendly people.
Everyone we met were very loving and very real. There was no facade.
I just feel like God is active here, and you can feel it in the way the people relate to one another. I love these people. I feel like we all love one another.
What we liked best is we just felt welcome here, that this is like a family.
This is the most remarkable group of people I have ever known.
Our children are growing up knowing God.
I really like the priest here, and the community is really fun.
But the idea is you know, we are unique in the area with our message, and we've created a unique space that hopefully, again, is transparent to the gospel. The whole point is to get out of the way so that Christ can shine through. And when we have people come here, we want them to experience that reality, that they want. We want them to see friendly people. We want them to hear the services done properly, in order with beauty as best as we can do them. We want them to see everything in a sense that says, you know, nothing is distracting. The message can pierce through somehow to their hearts also, and they can feel the warmth.
Actually, Molly and I were driving down the road, and we saw the sign where they're going to have a barbecue open house, and we were just a little curious, so we asked each other, do we want to check this out? And we said, yeah, let's do it. So I think it was a Saturday afternoon we pulled in, and the next thing we knew, we'd been invited to the Sunday morning, and we came in. It was quite culture shock's not the right word, but it was very unique from our past experience for churches. But that's.
But beautiful, yeah. Very beautiful. Yeah. It was very worshipful. That's what I really liked about it. Nobody was up front, quote unquote, performing, but it's all prayers and just worshiping God. The Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and that really appealed to me and to you.
Yeah. We have committed our lives to Christ for 30-something years ago, but we were searching for something more, something more community-oriented, and something that had more depth to the worship experience. And when we came in here, there was just something inside us just said, we're here.
One of the first things my father said when he visited, he said, wow, you have a very diverse congregation. He had met somebody who was Moldovan. We have Romanians, we have Russians, we have Greeks, we have Americans, American converts.
Our church, or Orthodox church overseas, a little bit different. The same everything, maybe walls, but the way people standing, they do not sitting. And for me, it was kind of, oh. What's this all about? But step by step, I got into the church, and now I have plenty of friends. That, for me, is very important.
We have black people, we have white people, obviously, and we have all over the spectrum, all sorts of visitors, not only from Eastern European countries, the Ukraine and everything, but just also a very solid core of people. Now, as far as age range, we have everything from late mid-70s to, you know, little kids. We have more kids now than we've ever had.
Well, I serve, I help the priest in the back altar. I have this job to do the censer and give it to him and put the incense in. And so I have to take it out for the great entrance. And I always carry the candles, and that's it.
If you go to the early church and you look at it, and you hear it called the Way. Now, the Way isn't simply an intellectual philosophy. The Way isn't simply a few practices. The Way embodies an entire praxis is the word, an entire holistic scope of the meaning of the gospel. And so what's unique about Orthodoxy is that the holism of the faith has been preserved. We don't simply approach things from the mind. We're not, for instance, a faith that is simply of the book. Although we have the Bible, we have the fullness of the scriptures. We are faith of tradition, but the tradition includes this holism. It includes the fullness of what have Christians always done in every generation. The worship is from the earliest centuries of Christianity. The architecture, the dogmatic teaching is in continuity with everything the early church stood for. There's a sense in the modern world that Christianity is relative. I can be a Christian and believe this. I can be a Christian and do this. I can act this way. Well, in the Orthodox Church, there isn't this relativity is missing. The statement would be is to be a Christian, you would do what Christians have always done and been in history, in reality, and then functionally, currently, by the power of the Holy Spirit, if we worship the same God, and we have and it's the same Jesus and the same Holy Spirit guiding the church, then we would understand that it should produce similar results, similar prayers, spirits, and types of, not types of people, but experiences of God. And that was something that was missing for me in the Protestant world that left me grasping for straws. I would go to this parish and I would hear this preacher say this about whatever topic, and I'd go to this parish and they would say something opposite on this issue, whether it was who Jesus was or just about anything was up for debate. And so I found myself grasping, you know, what is true? Of course, we would say that truth is, Christ is truth, and the truth is a person. But the problem in the modern era is that you're always wondering, you end up becoming your own pope. You end up deciding for yourself what is truth as you sift through the mountains and mountains of information. And what I was uncomfortable with was that I had met so many people that had decided their own truths in Christianity. Now, their truth may be manifestly different than every other Christian generation in the world. It may be completely unique and original to them, but it was their truth and they were okay with that. And I don't see much difference between that and the world. And that has never been the case in Christianity. And so there was a sense when entering the Orthodox Church that I wasn't entering into the space of my own ego or the space of my own interpretation of my experiences. This was no longer about validating me and my egotistical bents on my opinions about the philosophy of the Bible or whatever is being presented. This was a streaming continuity of the Holy Spirit throughout the generations that was confirmed in my life, but what it became was a sense of a deep well. I was a shallow well as I plumbed my own depths and worked with my own opinions. There was only so far I could go back. There was only so deep felt like I could go. When I entered the Orthodox Church, it felt like there was endless depths. There was no way to wrap your mind around. The scriptures became deeper. The worship became infinitely deeper. The spiritual practice of prayers and various things that have been done generationally had become significantly deeper. The historicity, no longer did I have to argue about things that had been established for 2,000 years. No longer were certain things up for debate. There wasn't anything really to argue about anymore, theologically, because the theologies had been laid out very early on, and we were in continuity with them. It became one of the things that was uniquely different is it became less about trusting myself and actually more about trusting God and by extension, often trusting the church, which was unheard of in my Protestant experience. You know, you there was always a grain of salt in the Protestant church because we knew that a lot of what was being taught came from men, because it was because we sat around and made our opinions too.
I'm Michael Muth, professor of philosophy at Wesleyan College. Was certainly not born Orthodox, was raised in the Episcopal Church, spent years in the Methodist Church. As a scholar, and out of personal interest, I've spent lots of time reading church fathers, reading medieval philosophy, medieval theology. So increasingly became less comfortable perhaps with a fairly modernized form of Protestantism and started looking back and thinking there's something about the nature of sacraments or something about the nature of reality that somehow isn't coming through for me. But there was something then within Orthodoxy, however, that began to address what for me, I have to admit, were very intellectual concerns. Being an academic, I in many ways live in my mind. And those things began to speak to me about a need for something, frankly, very other than what I had been experiencing. And certainly one of the things you experience in the liturgy in the Orthodox Church is something other. It's not Southern Protestantism.
We had a visitor came one time and said, you know, our kids are kind of move around during the church service, and she came up to me afterward and said, I can't tell whose child belongs to who, because the kids will go from person to person. Everybody picks them up, loves them, holds them, helps the parents. And to me, I mean, that's what this church is. It is such a community of people who come from different backgrounds and who are so different from one another. But in Christ, the unity is unbelievable. I mean, that's really all some of us have in common. And somehow God takes that and makes it a community of people who love one another.
Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to thy priests.
It's a very, very friendly community. And actually each one of ours, it's a friend of mine.
Because of our faith, our Lord, we have a bond that even if I don't know someone, there's a bond
raise
there.
Our God, raise thy right hand and bless this food and the work of your servants for the hour.
I'm kind of enjoying even talking. So we have meal after after church, enjoying the very good food and conversation, and it's part of our life.
Thank you so much.
God is looking for those who are truly seeking Him, and this parish is one that attempts to make itself transparent to Christ. Everything here is about Christ. And so we invite people in, and we have advertised in the past as come and experience the beauty of Lent. Come and experience the beauty of the ancient Christian liturgy. Come and experience all these things that we have to offer. But much more than that, come and try to make a life-changing, transformative connection with Jesus Christ. Try to enter in that stream which has been flowing for 2,000 years, which has sanctified innumerable saints throughout the ages. As far as you coming, come and relax. Many people are concerned when they enter a church about the formalities of sitting, standing. But for the most part, if you're simply polite and don't worry about learning the ins and outs, but come with an open heart, asking God to reveal Himself to you. And I haven't met too many who haven't had an experience of Christ being present with them as they did that. And that's really what people should come here for, is to find Christ and to find and have that encounter in their lives.